Jefferson. Thanks very much. Well, if you're worried about this, here's a sobering statistic. A recent UN report said that 1 in 8 deaths worldwide can be linked to air pollution. For more on the sometimes fatal health effects of dirty air, let's cross to New York. I'm joined by Darby Jack. He's a professor of environmental health sciences at Columbia University's Mailman School of Public Health. Thanks so much for being with us. We have just been hearing about two phenomena. One is the kind of air pollution we're all sadly growing accustomed to, industrial air pollution, car pollution. But the other is the way the planet has been working for millennia, even before humankind came on the scene, moving dust and topsoil and sand through the atmosphere. Both of them presumably are bad for us. Are they the same kind of bad?
Well, that's a surprisingly poorly understood topic, but the short answer is yes, that the dust is acting on your lungs in much the same way that the small particles from combustion act on your lungs, and that we need to worry about the dust just like we do regular air pollution, particulate air pollution from coal-fired power plants and engines and so forth.
So what can people do about it?
Well, for most people, it's an inconvenience, not an acute risk, but for people who are vulnerable, that is to say, people who have pre-existing heart disease or lung disease, who have asthma, women who are pregnant, it's important to stay indoors. And for the rest of us, it's probably a good idea to avoid exercising outdoors. When you exercise, you breathe harder and your inhaled dose of air pollution is a lot higher. So, for most people, just avoid exercising outdoors, but for folks in those vulnerable categories, it is really important to stay inside where the levels are typically lower.
And I'm just curious, we've all seen people cycling down the street with a bandana over their face or a mask over their face. Is anything you cover your mouth and nose with going to help much?
Not really. I mean, to filter out the really small particles, and it's the small particles that are most damaging for your body, you would need to use an industrial respirator that would be pretty uncomfortable to wear while bicycling or doing any kind of vigorous activity. But there are indoor air filters and so forth that can cleanse the air. But for the most part, and especially in a place like the UK where this is not a common occurrence, the best advice is to just take it easy for a few days until the problem abates.
I'm going to keep throwing ideas at you, but I'm getting a sense of where you stand. Mm-hmm. Does bathing more often, just trying to get the stuff off of your skin, help?
Well, it won't. It might make you feel better, but it won't really change the health risks. I mean, the health risks are due to the inhaled dose, the stuff you're breathing deep into your lungs, and that's really the small particles. And bathing won't address that problem. No.
So let me ask you, over the long term, as someone who studies the health effects on mm-hmm. people, should we be optimistic that this is getting better as the world slowly turns its attention towards reducing climate change? Or is it going to get worse, both industrial pollution and the Earth's own dirt as it circulates around?
Well, there's a couple of parts to that question. So in high-income countries in the United States and Europe, the problem has gotten a lot better over the last 50 years. The effective government regulation has really done a good job, and we all breathe, those of us who live in high-income cities, we breathe much cleaner air than our grandparents did, our parents did. But in developing countries, in low-income countries, middle-income countries, the situation is quite different. And there we do see high levels that have been sustained for a long time. And indeed, in many places where economies are growing rapidly without effective environmental policy, the problem is getting worse. As for the dust, I don't really know what we should expect in terms of the dust from the Sahara reaching Europe. I don't know what the forecasts are for that, frankly.
That is a big whole other question, Darby Jack of Columbia University. Thanks so much for talking with us.
My pleasure. Thank you.